Six things I wish I knew the first day of Berklee. And I'm not pulling any punches. All right, number one, focus, disconnect, and do not be distracted. I can't believe you mentioned Karate Kid. We'll see if I stumble across some accidental euphemisms, but my favorite part of the movies is the training sequence, where a young Bruce Wayne or Neo or Kung Fu Panda goes to a remote location to be trained relentlessly, nonstop, and past all of their breaking points until they emerge as a master. So the next few years can be your training sequence if you focus. But unfortunately, you're not in Siberia. You're surrounded by distractions. So you're surrounded by cool, tempting people hanging out casually, telling you to relax. But the problem is, the casual ones, and unfortunately, I can say this from experience, the casual ones end up having very casual talent and casual lives. Looking back, my only Berklee classmates that really got successful were the ones who were fiercely focused, determined, and undistractable. So while you're here, presidents will change, the world will change, and the media will try to convince you. The media will try to convince you how important it all is, but it's not. None of it matters to you now. You're being tested, and your enemy is distraction. So stay offline, shut off your computer, and stay in the shed. So focus, disconnect, and do not be distracted. This is your number one most important challenge. If you master focus, you're going to be in control of your world, not just now, but after. And if you don't learn to focus, your world will always control you. Number two, I love this one. Do not accept their speed limit. You know, you've been called the class of 2012 a couple times, but I have something to say about that. You don't get extreme results without extreme actions. Berklee classes set a pace that the average student can keep. If you want to be above average, you must push yourself to do more than is required. There's a martial arts saying, when you are not practicing, someone else is, and when you meet him, he will win. If you're a writer, yeah, stress on that. I used to have that written on the back of my notebook, and because I love that quote, and like my girlfriend would go like, you're freaking me out, don't, you know what I mean? Okay, anyway, if you're a writer, you should not only write a song a week, but spend twice as long improving it as you do writing it. Inspiration is a really good start, but it's the diligence to make every note and every word perfect that really sets you apart. Luckily, when I was 17, just a few months before I started Berklee, I met a man in Chicago named Kimo Williams, who used to teach here at Berklee, and he convinced me that the standard pace is for chumps. In just three intensive lessons, he taught me three semesters of Berklee harmony. So on opening day, I started in harmony four. In one intensive lesson, he taught me the whole semester of arranging one. Then I learned that I could buy the book for a course that I wasn't enrolled in, do all the examples myself without even needing to attend the class. Then I could approach the department head, take the final exam, and get full credit. And I double-checked you can still do this. So I did this for all of the other all of the other requirements, like arranging two and traditional counterpoint classes. It's not that I didn't learn them. I did learn them. It's just that I found out that I could do it in a couple weeks, and you didn't have to sit there for a whole semester and waste a credit that could be spent on something else you prefer doing. So I graduated Berklee in 2.5 years. Do not accept their speed limit. You save money that way, too. So, number three. This is another hard lesson learned. Nobody will teach you anything. You have to teach yourself. When I first arrived at Berklee, I was disappointed. My teachers weren't teaching me. I almost dropped out. I went home to Chicago and I got accepted at Northwestern University until I realized that their music program was more about memorizing the name of Bach's many children. So I came back to Berklee with gusto. I'm just like, all right, here we go. And I decided to squeeze every bit of knowledge out of this place I could, realizing nobody was going to do it for me. So do not expect the teachers to teach you. They will present information to you, but it's entirely 100% up to you to either make the most of it and use it, or waste your time here and go home and get a normal dumb job. Berklee's like a library. Everything you need to know is here for the taking. It's the best possible environment for you to master your music. But nobody will teach you anything. You have to teach yourself. Number four, learn from your heroes, not only theirs. When I was here, I wanted to be a great songwriter, among many other things. And Berklee's songwriting classes are amazing. The problem is that there was a lyric writing teacher who said, a good lyric must use all five senses. He'd say, don't just mention your grandmother, describe the veins on the back of your grandmother's hand. And don't just mention that you walked into the living room, describe the smell of the dust on the curtains and the sound of the stairs as you walked up. And, you know, because I really took it to heart, for years, I thought that every lyric I wrote was crap unless it used all five senses. And, you know, this really took me years to realize. And I was listening to some of my favorite songs by Nirvana or the Talking Heads, and I realized that they were like these abstract collages of evocative nonsense. And my favorite glitchy electronic music by Bjork was nothing they would ever teach you in a Rock Arranging for Live Performance 1 class. So I finally realized the one most important point I missed while I was here that I hope you don't forget. The teachers are taking their favorite music and they're using it to teach you these techniques. So learn and appreciate those techniques, they're great. But if you only learn the techniques they teach you, you're only learning their favorite music. Never think that their heroes are better than yours. While you're here, you're going to hear a lot about the greats, but anything you love is great too. The same way that they will break apart a Shania Twain hit song or a classic Charlie Parker solo to teach you the craft inside, you have to learn how to break apart your favorite music and analyze it. So it's only when I finally analyzed my favorite Nirvana and Talking Heads lyrics and finally analyzed the glitches and growls inside Bjork's music that I was able to distill their ingredients for my own reuse. So learn from your heroes, not only theirs. Two left. Number five, don't get stuck in the past. While at Berklee, I felt I had to learn Donna Lee, the old bebop jazz standard, in order to be a good musician. Then I got this great gig going to Japan for a month with Victor Bailey on bass. And here's one of the best bassists ever, who's played with Wayne Shorter, Joe Zawinul, Sonny Rollins, Sting, and a billion more. And I was sitting there, you know, practicing, and I played a little bit of Donna Lee. And he goes, man, jazz was all about inventing something new. He said, for a musician 50 years later to be stuck in the 1950s, that would be like a musician in the 1950s being stuck in the 1900s. There's nothing cool about that. I was like, sorry. Victor Bailey just chewed me out. So a couple weeks later, I was sitting at the piano quietly just working on one of my own songs, and he walked up behind me and he goes, dude, what is that? That's great, man. Can you show me that? And it's like for the first time he was impressed, and it was just some little thing I was working on my own. So don't forget that innovation is needed more than imitation. Don't get stuck in the past. Number six, when done, be valuable. While you're here, stay locked in the shed. You have to appreciate this wonderful isolation where you have no responsibility but to improve yourself. But when you leave here, head to the business aisle of the bookstore and start reading a book a week about entrepreneurial things like marketing. Never underestimate the importance of making money making music. You gotta let go of any weird taboos you have about it. Money is nothing more than neutral proof that you're adding value to people's lives. Making sure you're making money is just a way of making sure that you're doing something of value to others. Remember that this usually comes from doing the things that most people don't do. For example, how much did the world pay you to play video games? Nothing, because everyone does it. But how much does the world pay people to make video games? A ton, because very few people can do it and lots of people want it. So be one of the few that is clever enough to make money making music instead of pretending it doesn't matter. Be one of the few that has the guts to do something shocking. Be one of the few that takes your lessons here as a starting point and pushes yourself to do more with what you learn. Be one of the few that knows how to help yourself instead of expecting others to do it for you. And be one of the few that does much more than is required. And most importantly, be one of the few that stays in the shed to practice while everyone else is surfing the net, flirting on MySpace, and watching TV. Thank you.